Hello everyone, welcome to the HSPF training by DSI. This is the video HSPF 330. We will learn how to create an HSPF model in BASINS with multiple model segments. So in the last video, we discussed that all of these watersheds got same parameterization and same meteorological data. So what we will do is that we will create another attribute in this watershed shapefile, and that we will use for segmentation. So I go edit, add field, model seg, and let's call it a string for now. Click on OK. Okay. So now what we will do is that we will select the subwatersheds. For example, we select these two subwatersheds and we assign them a model segment. Now this can be anything. Right now, it could be, you could call it upstream, or you could be grouping these two subwatersheds based on their meteorological station, or based on their slopes, or based on their soil properties. So for now, what we will do is we'll open the NLDAS grid here. Okay, so based on this NLDAS grid, we see that we can provide same meteorological data to this subwatershed and this to these two subwatersheds. So that we can call it one segment. So the parameters of the operations in these two subwatersheds will be same. Similarly, we can assign these two subbasins same model segment. So that way we can go on and we can group all of these subbasins into different groups or segmentation, and based on the segment they are in, we provide them the parameterization. So the way you're talking about earlier, for example, a forest land use here, if these two model segments are in the, these two subwatersheds are in the same model segment, that means the forest in this subwatershed and the forest in this subwatershed will have same property. It will have different amount of area draining to these reaches, but it will have the same property. Now you can go ahead and you can decide that each individual subwatershed is a model segment on its own. And that is, a lot of people do that, especially when they have fewer subwatersheds. However, doing that means that you have to do far more parameterization. You have to get more information, making the model difficult. So this model segmentation, grouping subwatersheds based on the meteorological segment, soils, and these properties is a very regular practice that we do. Okay, so what we will do is that we will assign a model segment to some of these subwatersheds. Okay, so I went ahead and assigned a model segment to each subwatershed. Now I didn't do a very good job of it. I just for top upstream subwatersheds, I assigned it according to the grid, and for rest of them, I just gave the same NLDAS grid number. So let's click on close, and we'll repeat the same step: models HSPF, and we'll go through it quickly because we have seen all of this. Subbasins. Now we are using model seg as model segment ID field. What it means is that in met stations, it will ask me that for specific model segment, what met station it should get the data from. So it's smart enough, based on the number that I provided for model segment, it selected the proper met station. but it may not be so good every time. So you may be able to click on that and select a different station. Now, also it is possible that you may be using more detailed model segmentation than this NLDAS grids. So you may be providing same meteorological station to two different model segments, and you might want to differentiate that in the parameterization later on. So there are different configurations possible. So we'll click on OK quickly, and let's cancel it and call it snake_330. Okay. Okay, so BASINS created this UCI file. On the surface of it, it will look like it's a similar UCI file as before, but what we will first, we will change a little bit of timing so that we can run it quickly to see if it works. Click on OK and run it. And it's running. So now let's look at the UCI file quickly. Now, if you see, among other things, the difference between the previous one is that we have more per land operations. We have 400, 300, 400, 500. Let's look at general information block quickly. Okay, so we have 101 as the water wetlands, but 201, 301, 401, and 501. So we have five different model segments. So for the same land use, we can provide five different kinds of parameterization, depending upon where they are. They may have different slopes, different meteorological stations, these kind of things. So I think these couple of examples show you quickly how to make a UCI file from BASINS. Now there are a lot of steps additional. If you are doing it on your for your own project, you may have to process some more data, but I hope it sets you a path to achieve this objective. And in the next video, what we will do is we will look at this UCI file in more detail and see how the original parameterization that is provided by BASINS, how that should be changed before you even get into the process of model calibration or detailed model development. So that's it for this video. See you in the next one. Thank you.